OMG. I am just so ready, y'all. I'm so ready to get into this mother effing video. Hey, what's going on YouTube? It's Kevin and Mikel. We are back with a new video. I hope you guys enjoyed your weekend. I had a nice little weekend. I had a nice little breakfast yesterday at Continental. If you ever in Philly, go to Continental. You ever been there?
Yes.
18th and Market.
You promote all the food places. Hey,
bitch, what else you want me to promote? Okay. If the food was good, okay, and they had these great drinks and everything, shout out to Art, you know, because I wasn't doing that. He's going to text me, you know. So, you know, we went there, had a nice time.
That's cute, y'all. Yeah. You know,
we hang out from time to time. I don't know what you're checking my Instagram for, I mean, but anyway.
Who was checking your Instagram?
Yesterday.
How you know you were checking it?
Because he was right in front of my face, going through my stuff. Like, who's this and what's that about? And
I'm like, yeah, right.
But, you know.
Because you on a date with me and you on my Instagram.
Yeah, but it ain't nothing going on like that. You
know? Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah. But anyway, we had a nice little time together yesterday. And, yes. So, I do want to start this video by giving a congratulations to Iyanla Van Zandt for winning Outstanding Reality Show at the NAACP Awards. Because
when she told that woman, you going to tell her in her house that she can't.
Yes! The queen of the household.
Okay. Like, this is the queen. Now, let me get this straight. Y'all got a problem with her and her attitude in her house.
Yeah. And this fish stinks from the head. No, from the tail to the head.
Okay.
Not from the head to the top. Whatever she said.
She said,
yes.
That fish and that man's nuts.
It stinks.
You are the head of the household.
Oh, yeah. From the head to the tail.
From the head to
it
the
stinks.
Tail. It stinks.
And you are the head of the household. And it stinks. But, yeah. But, you know, I was just so happy because even though Iyanla won that award Friday night, she was so happy that she tweeted me. I don't know if she meant, I know she probably meant the Scorpion Show, but she tweeted me saying that, hey, did you hear I won an Image Award? Like, that's freaking crazy. Like, and all your happiness, you thought of us and tweeted us.
And you should have tweeted her back and said, hey, did you hear I want you back on the show? Okay? Because had she tweeted me that, I would have said, I did, congrats. Now, I'm going to be setting up for the next interview. Because I got a lot of shit I want to talk about with her.
Yes, and we need to have this lunch.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do. So,
her, yeah, that's
we
right.
We never had it yet.
No, we haven't. And, you know, I got a lot of shit to talk about. Because I know a few people whose lives I want her to fix. Okay?
Mm-mm-mm. So.
Okay.
Yes, so.
And I'll pay for it.
Congratulations to Iyanla. The NAACP Image Awards, it was okay. It wasn't the funniest NAACP award. You know, there was some good uplifting speeches, but I felt like, you know, sometimes the NAACP awards can seem like a sympathy award. And I don't ever want anybody to win an award from sympathy just because the Emmys or the Oscars and the, you know, the Golden Globes are not recognized who we think should win because of their color. Sometimes it's not even just about the color. Sometimes it's just that you've been outperformed by a better actress or a better actor. You know, it was just really good to watch, and I enjoyed the red carpet with Kevin Frazier and Tanika Ray. It was a really good ceremony. Kevin Hart took home 3 awards for his reality show, Entertainer of the Year, and Outstanding Actor. And, you know, I enjoyed him. I don't think Anthony Anderson should have been the host. I think Kevin Hart should have been the host. And congratulations to TV1 because for the next 5 years,
the Image Awards.
Yeah, the Image Awards will be on TV1, a black network. So shout out to them. And what else I have to say? A lot of people won. Brandy won. Wendy Barkel Robinson won her first one after being nominated like 10 times. Yeah, so y'all, you know, the normal people won. Lupita Nyong'o, Chiwetel Ejiofor, no, Forest Whitaker beat him out. It was just a good show. I wish that the Have and the Have Nots would have been nominated, but they wasn't. So, also over the weekend, Juror 8, you came out at the wrong time, but it was the right time because we would have went in on you on Thursday. But since you know, you want to release your statement on a Friday, talking about how...
Well, you got to explain who Juror 8 is.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Juror 8 was on the mic because I'm just so over it.
I know.
Juror 8 was a black girl on the Michael Dunn trial. Juror number 8 was a black girl who we felt at the time would be fighting for Jordan Davis and getting justice and saying that Michael Dunn was guilty in the first degree. We get a fucking chicken boo going on TV.
Chicken boo.
A chicken boo. A dumb motherfucker. Just dumb. Don't know nothing. Can't think right. They fucking seen her coming. They seen her come and said, "We want you. We want you on this trial." They ain't want nobody up there with some fucking sense.
Let me tell you. And what did I say to you last week when we were arguing about this? I said they don't need to be having these weak-minded ass people on there.
Yes.
Whose mind could be strained all different things. This, I'm not going to go
into a serious trial.
But this girl was on CNN and on MSNBC. On one of the interviews, y'all can go on YouTube. Just type in juror number 8.
Yes, juror CNN, number 8, CNN.
And then I guess juror number 8, MSNBC, and you'll see the interviews. This goofball of a goof had the nerve to say in one of the interviews, she wanted justice. And she didn't care if it was justice for Michael Dunn or Jordan Davis
or the other three guys that was in the car.
She just wanted justice. Now, what sense does that make to someone who has common sense? How you gonna go in there and say, "I want justice for either Michael Dunn or Jordan Davis"? Either one. That's like saying head to tails. Yeah. Tails. Dummy. When Kevin said they saw her a mile away coming, they literally saw her a mile away coming. Let me tell you something. Somebody like that, and I told Kevin this, if something was to happen to me down in Florida, God forbid, don't allow somebody like her to be on my jury. That is somebody that you don't want defending you. Mm-hmm. Okay?
I mean,
don't defend
me. First of all, when you go on TV, you're supposed to look a little presentable.
Presentable. Okay?
Her head had a big, blunt bitch. No. She just didn't look right. She didn't speak right. She didn't come off well educated.
No.
Then she had the nerve to answer one of the questions. Like, are you fucking kidding me?
Presentable, right?
Yes.
Right.
Oh, but yeah. You do look good.
Yeah,
you
do, I did that.
Oh, my God. But I give it to you. You looked real good yesterday for church.
Presentable, bitch.
Yeah.
This girl got the nerve to say, "I want justice." And the interviewer was so confused that she repeated it. She said,
"Justice?"
Yeah, she said, "Yeah, for either Michael Dunn or Jordan."
And then she said, "I couldn't tell if it was premeditated or not." Are you fucking kidding me? You listened to the trial, right?
She was in the...
You heard what the wife said. Anybody... What common sense would know that the wife was telling the truth or the fiance.
Right.
She was telling the truth. She contradicted everything that he said.
Right.
I don't know. Oh, this bitch telling the truth. And what did she got against her fiance?
Right.
Nothing.
Right.
This fucking man sat there on the trial and cried about a dog and didn't cry about killing Jordan Davis.
And she said she don't.
And she said, "I want justice for whoever." And let me tell you something. Florida... Y'all seen this bitch coming. Y'all, you know what? I just don't get it. First of all, how you going to have 6 people on for Trayvon Martin, then 12 on for Jordan Davis, for Michael Dunn trial. Then you got a dumb bitch on there. Then you had on the Jure Zimmerman. One of the bitches already sided with Jure Zimmerman. Calling him fucking Georgie, bitch. Like, she talking like she knew Jure Zimmerman. Oh, I didn't think Georgie was like that, like the black guy. Like, she didn't even say Trayvon by his motherfucking name. So she already had her opinion before she even got picked on the case. Florida, y'all have to do better when selecting these people. You need people with the fucking mind.
Florida saw her coming and said, "We got another nigga, y'all."
Yes, they did. They seen her coming.
"We got another one. Let's hang him for the world to see."
Yeah, it's like, she gonna get on TV, bitch, and think
it had the nerve to say, yeah.
You know what?
Yeah.
I wouldn't even let the world know I was that fucking dumb. If I just would have stayed out of, I wouldn't have been in no
fucking. Let me tell you something. The way we are describing this young lady, it's nothing even compared to how she really is when you see those 2 interviews.
Just listen to her speak.
Just look at her. Listen, just look. Like, they had this in the jury room.
One eye going one way, let me stop. Because it was the truth. But
she said, "I don't know who I want justice for. I just want justice for somebody." That means that you, she was out to lunch.
Yeah. When they were saying that, it was yelling and screaming going on in that room. I know it was against her.
Yeah.
Dumb bitch.
I said to her, "Are you here?" Hello? Who's flying the plane?
Yeah.
Okay? Because your autopilot is on, and I need a pilot to fly, okay?
Look.
She said,
I just want justice for either Michael Dunn or Jordan Davis. No, bitch. This ain't multiple choice. You got to choose one.
And okay. Think about it.
Think about
clearly. Remember, the jury going to say, they're going to say on Friday, first of all, it's 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Can we go to lunch?
Can we go to lunch at 5 o'clock?
And then he's like, well, your break is coming anyway. So we knew they weren't going to deliberate no more. Well,
let me tell you something. What's her name, juror number 8?
Kershawna Miles.
Kershawna Miles. Let me tell you something, okay? If you ever see me out in the woods fighting a bear, don't help me help the bear.
No, let me.
Because I got a better chance of getting my way out of it than with you helping me, okay? Because you are two rocks short of a bag, okay? Something's not right with her.
No, at all. And let me tell you something, bitch. The next time jury duty notice come in the mail, you don't go back.
Don't call. Because I can see her
don't
now.
Show up.
I can see her now. Oh, yeah, this was fun last time. Let me go. No, don't go. Don't go. Because we don't need people like you, Kershawna Mills. Stephanie Mills' little cousin. We don't need people like you on the jury, okay?
No, not at all.
You had, and then what did she say about Michael Dunn? She thought he was a nice guy.
Yeah, she thought he was Michael Dunn was a nice guy. Now, excuse me. Anytime I'm on a case and I already deliberated, I'm going to look on the internet afterwards to find out what they didn't tell us.
Right.
And we've seen that he said black men need to be shot by these white people because they be getting out of line. He wrote this in a letter. But then you saying, you still get on TV and say, it's not about race.
It's not about, she's.
Are you fucking kidding me? Are you kidding me? No, because it just make me mad that we just live in this country where everything is so black versus white, and black, you're on the bottom, then it's the Latinos, then it's the Asians, then it's the white people.
Right. But wait a minute. Stop judging white people. I said that last week in our video. I said the same exact thing. When you said that one jury said, oh, it wasn't about race, don't sit here in my face, because when you say that, then that makes me think that you think that I'm dumb if you think that I'm going to believe that it's not about race.
It was
and
definitely about race.
And this coon of a coon got on national television and said she didn't think it was about race. Well, then what'd you think it was about, sweetheart? A phone call?
Because he got mad or he got road rage because he wouldn't turn down the motherfucking music.
And how about the guy who ran over the guy at the gas station?
Yes.
What the fuck?
And then them two was fighting. He rode him over. Two old men. In Las Vegas, fighting. At a fucking gas station.
And random over. Random over.
You know what? This is the...
Random over. Hit him once. Then hit him twice. Yeah, then random over.
We as a country need to get it together.
No wonder why other countries' healthcare is free. Because...
they charge you the
people like Kershawna Mills needs to be paying for healthcare.
Yes.
Because it's clearly it's not going to her brain.
Child.
She needs a CAT scan.
I'm done with her. Like
she said, when they asked her a question, yeah.
They need to do personality tests and character tests before we
what did you say?
Jury.
They saw her coming.
They saw her coming. Soon as she came in the room.
Listen,
as you know.
They know they watching.
They all talked to each other who we were on this case.
They pulled her, because you know they pulled you to the side. Individually, ask you
questions.
When she got up from that chair after she told what she needed to say to them, they looked at each other and said, "Yep, we got another one."
Yep, my lip is so I got it. I keep putting this down.
And she couldn't wait to do jury duty. And she couldn't wait to get her happy ass on TV.
Tell my author, George Michael Dunn was a nice guy. After hearing that, he shot at a car. The motherfucker drove to the hotel and called and ordered pizza and walked the dog and never called the cops.
Never called the cops.
How the fuck you think that's a nice guy, Chicken Boo? How do you think that's a nice guy?
Somebody needs to find Kershawna Mills and send her this video.
No,
sit there and watch. Because she's a Chicken Boo, a Jigaboo, all of the above. She's every dummy in the book.
You
because
are.
When y'all see her on TV, y'all gonna be like, and then on top of that, she's not 15, she's 21.
21.
So she's an adult. But she's acting like she's 12.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like what?
I just want to help. I wanted justice for somebody.
It was not about race. I never thought of as a white man shooting a black man.
Where do they find these? Where do you think they found them at?
Florida, because they're not uneducated. You know, some stuff Frank Taffy say, which is mean. Some stuff he say about us is the truth that we don't want to admit. But, you know, I got to get on Frank Taffy.
No, because I'm educated.
Oh, no, but everybody's not educated.
But not all white folks is educated
either. No, they're not.
Okay? Because I come across quite a few poor white trash. So I'm not even going to give
but you know, but,
taffy that credit.
But you know what? You see white trash, it's like bad white
trash. No, but I'm saying, my thing is, well, what Frank Taffy said, he said it in an ignorant and
demeaning way. Very ignorant. Now, let me just say, because, you know, last week I said, yeah, Frank Taffy is good TV, because he's an antagonist. He likes to go back and forth with everybody. But I wasn't here, and what I didn't know, because, you know, every race talks about each other at the kitchen table.
Not me.
You ain't gonna.
I don't talk about
them. Everybody talks about race at the kitchen table. No. But I'm not gonna get on camera or get on no audio and talk that shit, you know, about any race. And what Frank Taffy did was just.
I will. I'll talk about the blacks. Because I'm one of them.
Oh, yeah. So I'll talk about the blacks.
I'll talk about them real bad. I'll talk about them. Kashauna Mills. You know what, Kashauna Mills? They need to put you on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
No, she went. She was not the first fucking question.
She said,
she might see final answer. Like, no,
the fact that she said justice, that she wanted justice, and then, I'm sorry that you, I had to jump back to this, but the fact that she said justice, and an interviewer said justice, mm-hmm. Like, she was confused, like,
for who?
For who? For who do you want it for?
I'm over, and I'm getting mad thinking about it. So, you know, Frank Taffy, he was just exposed over the weekend. Now, before he got exposed, I was watching him on HLN because I know he's an antagonist. He's a Michael Dunn fan.
They need to sit him and Kashauna Mills at the same table.
Oh, he would love her. Bitch, you want to talk about nigga loving? Nigga lover. He would love her. Because she fits right into the mold that he's talking about. Are you kidding me? Now he sat up there and said, blacks ain't nothing. Black life is validated only unless a white person kills you or until a white person kills you. That black men ain't no good. They're only good for the NBA. Otherwise, we had the world's tallest garbage men. Like, he spewed a lot of hate. He called Oprah a nigger. He didn't say nigger. He said nigger. Oprah's a nigger.
She's a nigger. And she's trying to help her homeboy, Obama.
Yeah. Like, he went in on his white supremacist radio show. They're going to try to sue. Said, I'm going to sue Mother Jones for saying I tweeted this stuff. No, but you didn't tweet a motherfucker.
No, first he said it wasn't his account.
Yeah, it wasn't my account.
Then he said, no, first he said it wasn't his account. Then he said, oh, it was hacked. So the guy said, was it his account or was it hacked? Which one was it? See, you can, what? Don't I always say this? If you let somebody keep talking, they'll eventually tell them themselves.
Yes, they will.
And he said, he told, sat right there and told him, oh, what's that? That's not my account. That's not my account. And I'm suing so-and-so. Oh, no. It was hacked.
He's talking about, oh, that's terrible. That's horrible. I would never. Nancy Grace got his ass together on that show. Because I guess she must have just had a feel of him at the year and a half of being on that show. She just is like, if he made these statements, like he's never been back with H&M, he shouldn't be on no television show ever. Again, like you don't need people that's blatant racist like that spewing that hate. Like,
it's one thing if, I'm sorry, but it's one thing when you're undercover racist and we don't know. Mm-hmm. But you get on the radio and call Oprah a nigger and say that we all know that the white women is paying help, got her to where she's at. Because the black people, what do you think?
Because the black people ain't doing it. Oprah is a fucking worldwide icon. Okay? Oprah helps everybody. It's not just white people, Taffy. It's blacks, whites, Asian, Latinos. It's everybody. Oprah is a billionaire. Oprah had that effect. Well, bitch, you might sell 1,000 copies in 1 week. You go on her show, bitch, you done sold over 100,000 copies.
Okay.
Oprah had that effect because Oprah is a positive person. Oprah isn't a negative person. And she only wants positivity around her, okay? Oprah ain't got time for the negativity. And don't think you're going to come on my show and lie, make a lie up. Mm-hmm. And don't think I'm going to have you back on there and not confront you, bitch.
Okay, I was at home. I came home from school. And she sat on that couch and said, okay, so you lied about that.
Yeah.
Then had his mom back, too. Because you know his mom was on the first show, too. And defended him. Then she had him back and his mom sitting on him. Oh, so mom, so you knew he was lying. Mm-hmm. So what kind of mother are you?
Like, Oprah... Like, you ain't never heard nothing where Oprah was rude to anybody. Oprah is cheating on somebody. You don't never hear that. All you hear is Oprah done bought a fucking island or a house or has a new show.
And if anything that she does that somebody may be offended, Oprah will call them like she did with Rihanna. She had that nice long
pajamas. Yes,
They was going in on each other. No, don't do that, Rihanna. She's like, oh no, I wasn't like that. I wouldn't even do that to you.
I wasn't trying to put Barbara on you against you.
Right, but Rihanna told her, don't play, okay? Because I would have went.
She said, I'm from Harlem.
Okay, if the coins is right.
And she did. The coins are right.
Okay, I'm from Harlem. You're from the backwoods of Mississippi. You better watch it. Better watch where you stand, because I'll grab a from one of those trees. Don't do that. I get a switch from one of these trees.
Yeah, Frank Taffy just really trying to, and I hope that we never see him again. Like, he could keep his racist comments on his radio show and just keep to himself. Like, what bugs the fuck out of me is that you have these people now, they're online, you don't see it till black people face. All this racism that you have and you don't see it now unless it's a group and they find people and kill them and murder them. Mm-hmm. Like, otherwise, one-on-one, you ain't going to nobody face spewing that fucking hate. Mm-hmm. Like, I've experienced racism before. Remember I told you about that time that white girl called me a monkey. Mm-hmm. But that's like the only time that I can think of. And I was already like lit. Oh, I'm not going to argue with a white woman in no street. But it's just not going to happen. So if you are a racist, just keep it to yourself and pray for change. Like, you should never hate a race because they are a different color than you. Yes, we do things differently, but that doesn't mean you to think that you're better. Any better, we all pee, shit, bleed, and have the same stuff. We all go through the same things. The only thing different is the skin color and our cultures. That's it. But there's no reason to hate somebody because they're different. And it's a shame that in 2014 we have to say this, and we're still going to have to say it because it's people like Taffy that have children and embed it into their children's head. I don't know if he have any children, but he embedded in people's head that, you know, white is the superior race. Black people are nothing. They're the scum of the earth. Don't be friends with them. They're thugs. They're this. They carry guns. They fight. They do that. Black people will always have to fight to get to where we need to be because no one just fucking pulls a hand up, bitch. We got to climb up the ladder to get wherever we need to go. If it's in movies, if it's in fucking radio, if it's just anything, you got to work your way up. We don't have nothing easy. And it's good to hear how someone works their way up a ladder instead of just being helped because of their race. Shout out to Oprah. Oh,
that's that nigga.
Yeah.
Shout out to that nigga. Since she's a nigga. Shout out to her.
Ain't nobody pull Oprah to the top. Oprah did that shit on her own. She had a fucking television show in Chicago going against Phil Donahue. And just having a local fucking audience, she was beating him in the ratings. They said, you know what? We're going to give you a syndicated show. And then went on for 25 years.
Knocked him off of TV. And Phil Donahue at the time was one of the biggest TV hosts on television.
I used to think it was this old man.
Won't he do it?
Yes, he will. And I miss Sally because Sally was my girl. But, you know.
Moving on.
Don't do Sally like that.
No, I'm just saying, you know.
Sally was my girl. Shout out to Sally Jackson.
She was all our girls.
Yeah, her and PJ. I still remember PJ. And don't act like Chili wasn't on there when she found her dad. Like, I still remember that. So, and couples news, okay?
Yes!
Didn't I draw
her? Yes! What was her name? What's Chili the real name? LaWanda or something?
Rosanna.
Yes,
and one of the sisters, like, I loved her, like, not even just because she's my sister. Look for it. I know it's on the internet. And tell them we sent y'all. So we're going to talk about these couples now. Paula Patton and Robin Thicke confirmed to People Magazine that they have decided to separate.
For anyone who cares.
Yes. You know what? I think I do care. That's why I'm talking about it. Because they've been together over 20-something years. Like, they've been dating since their teens. But let me tell you something.
But can I just say this?
Go ahead.
I hate to say it. And don't you really mean it. Yeah, you have it. I seen it coming. You know why I saw it coming?
Oh, don't try to steal my words, bitch. That's why you cut me off.
No. You know why I saw it coming? For a long time, Robin Thicke went from here.
Oh, there you go. You taking my fucking word, bitch. Because that's what I was about to say.
He
went ain't nobody give a fuck about no Robin.
He
Thicke.
Went from here. See, great minds think alike.
That's right.
We've been sitting next to each other for 6 years.
Yeah, and then he started.
Robin Thicke went from here. Because the first time I saw Robin Thicke was in 2007 at the Beyonce Experience when he opened up for her.
Oh, wow.
He
I
went from
him.
Here. Mm-hmm. And gradually started coming here, and coming here, and coming here. Mm-hmm. And then not only that, but last year he had one of, if not the biggest songs,
he did,
on
song.
The radio.
Yes.
Robin Thicke's star has been rising and rising and rising and rising and rising for like the past 5-6 years. Mm-hmm. Paula Patton is an actress. She's a very good actress. But Paula Patton has been here for a long time. Okay? Mm-hmm. For a very long time. For some strange reason, I just could not see Robin Thicke just being stuck with her. And I hate to say that. I hate to say it. Because
Robin just started smelling himself because the pussy just kept being thrown
there
at him.
You
that's
go.
What happened.
There you go. He started
that's
smelling himself. And then he started smelling himself. And then he started hanging around with certain guys who also like
see, that's himself. When your marriage, that's when God tests you. And you know, Robin
that's
fell.
Robin Thicke was tested. God said to Robin Thicke, I'm going to take you from here, and I'm going to bring you on up here. But the test is going to be if you can actually remain privately in your love life, if you can remain here when I take you up here. But he couldn't remain down here. Why? Because as his star was rising, so was his... He was leaving Paula. Because
nobody was throwing their pussy at Robin Thicke before.
Hell
Robin.
No, wasn't nobody throwing no pussy
all
at Robin Thicke.
Oh, you think like, oh, look at that wannabe black guy. He always sing that R&B stuff.
Now
and then, bitch, I got to give it to Pharrell because he changed his whole sound. Like that new album, Blurred Lines, that new album, ain't nothing R&B about that album. Everything is pop. And I dance. I use some of the songs in my workouts when I do my Focus C25. Like Robin's whole image just changed, and he got more pussy being thrown at him. Then he in the clubs, he might be drinking, he's fondling the girls, fill up on.
And then he's nice looking. He's not a bad looking guy,
you know.
It just wasn't going to happen. See, Robin Thicke. See, the thing is, you got some really nice looking couples, and like for instance, you got couples like Will and Jada, Beyonce and Jay-Z, who have stood the test of time. That's because when one of them rose, or when they both rose, the other one didn't forget who was still at home.
That's right.
Will didn't forget that Jada was still at home. Jada didn't forget that Will was still at home. Beyonce didn't forget that Jay was at home, and he didn't forget that she was at home. But for some strange reason, Robin's star just started to grow. And I mean, if you ask me, I personally think that they split up because of probably something that Robin
that
was doing.
Did.
I don't think it was something she was doing. I think it was something he was doing.
Because every time we see Paula, she's the life of the party. Okay, that's all I'm going to say. When they together, she's the life
of the party.
Of the party.
And I know where you're going with that.
All right. Hey, Mary. Yeah, so...
Okay. Because let me tell you something. She...
That's not good. I'm not going to stop. That's good. So then, the other type of news...
Okay. Because I was there. Yeah. I saw it face to face. I said, what the shit?
Oh, stop. And other news.
Whatever she had. I
have what she's having.
I have what she's having. I don't need a drink.
So, and other couple news. There's this huge rumor going around that Brandy and Ryan Press have called it off. Called off the engagement. Now, look. I haven't talked to Brandy about it. First of all, I don't want to call Brandy like, girl, is it true? Like, no, I don't want to do that. But I just want to say, if it is true, I am wishing them the best. You know, because Brandy has been looking for love for a long time, and she's been so tired of having her heart broken. And, you know, I really thought that he was the one for her and everything. But every relationship has their issues. And I just hope that it's not enough for them to just break up, because now, you know, he done got to know the family. He got to know her daughter and everything. Like, for them to just, I just hope that he didn't do nothing bad or that she did anything bad. And I hope that they can work it out. That's all I'm going to say about that situation. So shout out to Brandy. Keep your head up. You got the game coming on next week. I'm hoping to hear about some new music and some new movie roles. Brandy, you belong. Like, Brandy... Still got to say this. Brandy should be. There's no reason why she's not doing movies and television at the same damn time and releasing music. Brandy can do that. She's fucking Brandy Norwood. She's been in the game over 20 years. Why isn't she in a movie since Temptation? Are you fucking kidding me? Brandy, get on the movies. Get back and do them. Just do the fucking thing like you're Brandy, okay? Don't you forget that. And don't y'all fucking forget that neither. You know, she had Barbie dolls, the first black Cinderella. Come on, sold out albums, tours, Grammy Award winner. Like, let's not sleep on Brandy. That's all I'm gonna say. Brandy, keep your head up.
Well, this is what I'm gonna say. If it is true, Brandy, me and you can go out to lunch together because you know I'm single too. And we can have girl talk.
Oh, you know what? I'm not gonna go there.
Yeah, don't.
I won't.
Cause I'll kick you out if you go.
Where you gonna kick me at? Man, I ain't going nowhere. So today, okay, you gonna be quiet for this segment because I know you probably ain't got nothing to say. So today,
what segment is
okay,
it?
Okay, the WWE has launched their network.
I'll be right back. I'm going to the
bathroom. So the WWE released their new network. It's called the WWE Network, and I am very happy for Vince McMahon, Stephanie McMahon, Triple H. Linda McMahon, I'm happy for the whole WWE because what Vince did was something that's groundbreaking, and I found out why Vince McMahon didn't want to do it with the cable networks.
Why?
Because they wanted too much money.
Remember we was having that conversation?
Yes, we was. He said they wanted too much money, and you know, now pay-per-view, now these cable companies, they are pulling out of the pay-per-view because they're like, bitch, if you selling your pay-per-view for $10 a month, nobody's going to buy pay-per-views from us, and you're taking away our money. So we're just going to cut you off. Some cable companies cut Vince McMahon off, but you know what, Vince? I'm happy for you. Nobody can argue $10 a month, your whole wrestling library, and they're getting live shows on the network. Like it's a damn television network. Like, it's 24/7. They have schedule blocks, and they have stuff you can watch on demand. So you can either watch what they got on, or you can be like Netflix and just watch old pay-per-views from the past. Every last pay-per-view was on there. Shout out to all of my wrestling fans, okay? For $10 a month, would you rather spend $10 a month or $55 a month for a pay-per-view?
$10 a month.
I'm going with the $10 a month. Nice. And that's what Vince McMahon is banking on. Everybody giving him the $10 a month instead of paying $55 a month to this cable company. Bitch, I could just make the money on my own. So Vince, what you did was fucking genius. Like, if these cable companies are going to try to take all of my money, fuck that. I'll just do my own network and do pay TV. Nobody's going to argue with that. So Vince, that's groundbreaking. That's fucking being a fucking visionary. Like, Vince McMahon, you have your ways, but you're very creative. You are a creative genius, unlike some others that call themselves that. So, I'm happy with the network. And to all the parents out there, if you can do it for your kids, it's only $10 a month. Versus, and all the pay-per-views, $10, all the wrestling you want for your kids, they can just watch it on their iPhones, their tablets, the computer, or on the Xbox or whatever. Like, you don't... It's just, I'm just very happy for them. And I know it seems like I'm promoting them, but I've been watching WWE since I was a kid, okay? So, it's just, I'm just so hyped that I can watch my stuff. When Mikal came here, I was watching wrestling. Like, it just is what it is. So, congratulations to Vince McMahon and the WWE on their new network, the WWE Network. We were talking about so much shit on Thursday that we forgot to talk about Candy, Todd, Oprah, Whoopi Goldberg going in on Mama Choice on The View.
Okay.
I just thought it was great. I thought it was great TV. I thought it was great because now you got, first of all, you got an Oscar winner telling you that your mom is wrong and your mom, all your mom can do is just sit there and grit her teeth.
That's what she's doing. Okay. Gritting them hard. Well, he told Candy, you know, when he said I'd leave you, and then Riley said to me, you don't say that. You just don't say that.
Yeah, like, Mom, just 'cause you have your computer all the time.
Well, you know, because Todd, and I don't really have nothing against him. What what?
She has
everything against him. And I love what Ty said. I have a mother too. Yeah. He should have went a little farther. Because I would have elaborated. I just said, I have a mother too. And she's dying to meet her. Oh. If he would have said that to her,
bitch,
she would have turned around and look. She would have said, and I'm dying to meet her. That would have been that would have been the show.
Okay.
Now, why didn't I get tickets in that episode?
Oh, because I would have been saying something.
I'd have been, okay, I'd have been in the audience, too. You know what? She's wrong. Daisy, you got to be quiet, though.
Whoopi was like, Whoopi was like, do you ever marry Mama Joyce? She's like, yeah.
No, she don't.
Was Candy in your business?
No. No. She wasn't in my business.
Well, why don't you just let Candy make her own mistakes?
Right.
That audience went off.
She told her, get Mama Joyce. You and I are hop, skip, and age, okay?
She did say that. A hop, skip, and a jump.
Because our mothers let us make our mistakes.
Okay.
But you know what I didn't like? I wanted somebody to apologize to Todd because I didn't like how they kept saying, you got to let her make her own mistakes. Basically making it seem like Todd is a mistake. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because he may not be a mistake. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? And I wish they would have stopped using that particular phrase in front of him.
Mm-hmm. I can't like, don't say, you know,
yeah,
if they do hit their roadblock, let her deal with that.
But I'm not really thinking about King. I'm thinking about Riley. No, you are not. No, you're not. So why are you still beating that lie into that wig, okay?
Yeah, I'm so mad. Mama Joyce and Carmen. Like I forgot to talk about how she told me I'll drag you from here up and down the streets. Mama Joyce, mind your business
before your old ass gets dragged from here to Shady Pines. Okay, you know what, Candy, and then Candy goes, yeah, I can't tell.
Candy broken down crying. Like, Candy, the act is over, okay?
Yeah, Thank you, Kevin. It's over. The act is over with Candy. We all love our mothers. But let me tell you something. If Marcita tried to tell me who I can and cannot sleep with...
All right. Go off. Has she ever told you that, bitch?
I don't agree with that. No. You know why? Because, first of all, who I'm messing with is none of her business, mm-hmm. okay? And she tried to get into that little roadblock with my sister and her boyfriend.
Ooh. Go on. So,
but you know what?
Did they get along fine?
No.
I mean. Without saying too much?
They still go back and forth with each other. Okay. But see, this is my thing. I'm going to tell you something. I'm playing the fence. I am playing the fence. I am. Because on one side, I see where my mom is coming from. Okay. And the things that she has against him. I see it.
All right.
But on the other side, I see where my sister's coming from. You have to mind your business. And you also have to stop saying certain stuff because at the end of the day, that is my boyfriend. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I'm your mother and this is my house, okay? Mm. I see exactly where they're both coming from. Because one day, me and my sister got into a huge argument, okay? And my mom was trying to break us up. When I say huge argument, this almost went out her mouth. And let me tell you something. When we was going through it, her boyfriend was sitting right there on her bed and didn't utter a word. Because let me tell you something. If he would have, then it would have been hell to pay. Because number one, when I'm talking to my sister, you don't say a word. Mm. So we were going at it. And my mom's trying to break us up. Then all of a sudden, I said, and why the fuck don't he? And then my mom turned around and said, yeah, why don't? Because so my mom went from being a peacemaker to jumping on my side. Because I knew my mom don't like him. So that was the trigger. Then he got up and said, oh, time to go. Sure the fuck is.
Well, how long ago was this?
This was a few months ago.
Oh, wow.
Bye. Get out.
But don't treat him like that.
No, I'm not treating him like that. But you know what? Like I said, I play the fence. Because I see where my mom's coming from and I see where my sister's coming from. And at that particular moment, I saw where my mom was coming from. You know what I mean?
I mean, just through, because I don't know nothing about their relationship, but just through the picture, no, they seem like...
No, and you know what? People. Let me tell you something. I would never want my sister and him to break up because that is who she really loves and cares about. And they've been together for like 3 years, 3 or 4 years. So I'm like this. Do y'all. I don't ever want to see y'all breaking up if that's what makes you happy. I don't want to see it. But let me tell you something. He's a little too old not to have manners.
Oh, well, see, that's
the problem.
Okay.
He's a little too old not to have manners. And see, my mom is from the old school. My mom is one of those people, when you walk into somebody's
house, I knew you was about to say that. Like, that's for anybody. Like,
that's common fucking sense.
Somebody's house and then not speak.
You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying.
I feel like I got something.
First of all, that's my mother's house where she paid. Who the fuck do you think you are?
Just walking up in here, or bitch, I come in my house and you don't speak.
Let me tell you something. Whatever. Whenever I walk through your front door, I speak when I come in that front door.
Yes.
Because I don't live here. I speak whenever I go to somebody's house. Who the fuck do you think you are to walk up in here and not speak?
Mm-hmm. Go off.
I don't give a fuck if you and her have been laying together for 3+ years. You keep it up, she'll be living with you, bitch. And you don't ever have to worry about speaking up in here.
Oh,
because you won't have to come here to see her. Fuck you and her.
No, don't say
no,
that.
No, but I didn't get up. You know, not fuck you and
her. He's in his mold right now.
But you know what I mean.
Yes. So.
That's why I said I play the fair. Because then, hey, and then there's times when I jump on my sister's side. And I'm like, Mom, you really, 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 really need to mind your business. You know what I mean? She really does, because there's some things that my mom, and then my mom likes to antagonize my sister when it comes to her boyfriend. And it's like, I listen to her when it comes to certain stuff. I listen to my mom and I just be like, you can't do that. You know what I mean? Like, you can't do that because you're almost kind of making her feel bad about dating him.
But where your dad come in at?
Oh, my dad, he don't.
He just don't care.
Let me tell you something. Because let me tell you something. He knows not to play with my dad.
Let me tell you something.
When my sister introduced him to my dad.
Don't say your dad.
My sister and him was dating. Him and my sister was dating for a year before my sister told us that they was dating. When my sister finally introduced him to my dad, the first thing my dad said to him was, come here, let me talk to you. And took him and had that conversation.
Mm-hmm. I know that's right.
So you know he don't.
I mean, it's good to start off that way.
He knows that my mom. He knows that my mom don't like him. So what I think it is, he's like a little nervous about her. So he don't really know what to say because he's like,
I'll just say
hi and keep it moving. And keep it moving. But don't not say anything.
Yeah.
Because then that's where the problem lies.
All right. So Mikhail got a little mama juice in his family. All right.
To an extent.
and he plays defense.
And so I play
Candy,
defense.
Candy don't have a relative.
That play defense.
Because her brother passed away.
I have to play defense because I don't want my sister to think that everybody's against her. But then I don't want my mom to think that she's always right.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to play defense. The thing with Candy, like you said, she don't have somebody playing defense and being the peacemaker. You know, all her aunts and them is on Mama Joy's side.
Yeah, because they all want the checks to keep rolling.
And then Candy is taking Mama Joy's side. Out of respect. And then she's leaving Todd on the battlefield by himself.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But let me tell you something. If I was Todd, or if I was that little voice in Todd's ear, if you're going to leave me on the battlefield, guess what? Let me pack up my shit and I'm going to go the fuck out. Because you won't leave me on this field by myself. Okay? Because last time I checked, no soldiers fighting the war by themselves. Okay? Mm-hmm. They got about 500 other people fighting with them. Fuck that.
Mm.
Okay?
So we talked about Mama Joyce and them. Now we're going to get into the Real Housewives of Atlanta episode that was last night. And I have some stuff to say. And you know what? I really, really enjoyed last night's episode. And the only, like, I loved how, first of all, let's just talk about how it started off. Y'all know how I really hate discussing everything that happened, but a lot happened within the episode that it can't go without being said. So, you know, the episode starts off, Nene, who's always right, is talking about what
always
happened.
Right?
Always have to be right.
She's right.
Explaining to, you know I got to be right. And I'm a fuck. And I'm gonna talk about myself when I talk about friendship.
Oh,
yeah, I'm gonna talk about myself. So, you know, she's explaining to Greg about, you know, why she did what she did at the event, and how how Peter needed to stay in his place, and blah 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 blah. The whole time I was thinking, Nene, you needed to be got together at that time. Peter shouldn't have been the one to do it. Cynthia was the one to do it. But Cynthia would never be the bitch to put you in the place. Cynthia tell me, oh, but it wasn't the time. She telling her sister, oh, this wasn't the time or the place. Yes, it is. the time and the place to get her together. Just pull her to the side and say, Nene, you know you're at an event and this is not a good look for you. This is being in your honor. You know, you can't go out there and act like that. I think you should, you know, get yourself together. Like, it's nothing wrong with pulling your friend to the side and getting them together. My friends do it all the time. Like, bitch, calm down. Like, don't get too hyped. Don't do this. Don't do that. Like, it's not. It's nothing wrong with getting them, putting your friend in check. So, you know, everybody's talking about how they're going to throw this event for Peter's birthday party. It was a really nice birthday party. I love how she had the Jamaican theme, and I loved how they were wearing the green and the yellow, or the red. Like, everybody looked islandy to me. A lot of people look nice, okay? I'll just say that. It was nice, islandy, and how the fuck you don't know you have a white Jamaican band? I don't know. But I think you probably was looking for the cheapest price, okay? That's how you got the white band. But the music sounded Jamaican to me, so it was no issues there. My issue was, Nene, you still have this hunch or this chip on your shoulder against Kenya. Yeah. You have this chip on your shoulder against Marlo. You are just walking around with this sour face like somebody didn't fuck you right, or, you know, like somebody really, really did you wrong. Like, first of all, there's a time and a place, again, for everything. You walked in there
late.
She's always late. She's always been late.
Didn't get mad at Candy for being late. No, but you know, Candy is always late.
She apologized, but sometimes you have to accept people for who they are. If you tell me 1:30, bitch, sometimes it's 1:40 or 1:45 for me.
Yeah.
Kevin Mikel, I'll be there at 5:15. Bitch ain't show up to 5:35. But I'm not mad, you know?
Because I get there.
Yeah, he got here. Russell's gonna come on in today. Oh. You text me today. I'm gonna be here at 5:15. Bitch, you ain't get 5:35.
Oh, that's because I had to go all the way up to the car dealership and sign the paper.
But that's all right. What the fuck I got to do?
Yeah, but I gave you a warning. Don't get warnings.
You know? So Marlo's there. Nene don't want to sit next to Marlo. She don't want to talk to Kenya. You know, she barely wanted to give Peter a hug. Peter is one of the people who like, bitch, once I get you on check, it's still love. I still love you.
Right.
You know, Peter is not, I don't want to be friends with Nene, or Cynthia, you can't talk to her because she's a bitch and la 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 la. No. Like, Peter is kind of like a parent to me. Like, parents will beat your ass or get you together when you need to be gotten to.
And they still love you.
And still love you, you know? So she, I want to do that, and I'm only here because Cynthia wanted to be here. Cynthia is my friend, so I didn't want to not just show up. So, you know, Kenya's trying to have a regular conversation with Nene. And Nene is mad because Nene, by that time I understood that, oh, Nene is upset because of the budding friendship between Marlo and Kenya. So I'm like, okay, I mean, I'm thinking, like, you can't tell people who they can and cannot be friends with, especially on a show like The Real Housewives of Atlanta. You can't do something like that. And something that I've never heard from anybody yet, not on Twitter, not on these people that do the YouTube reviews, is this. You have to remember, Kenya is an associate of Nene Leakes. Marlo is an associate of Nene Leakes. They met up, from what I remember, if my memory serves me right, they met up in that fucking salon where Salon was doing Marlo here, because Lawrence said Marlo is cool like that, okay?
But Nene said that Phaedra brought Marlo on.
Well, whether Phaedra brought Marlo on or not.
Well, she said that. Where did she say that on?
She said that on...
Was it her blog or was it actually on the show?
I can't...
She said it somewhere.
I can't remember.
Phaedra actually bought Marlo.
I think it was on Friday the View. It might have been the View.
Oh, it was on the View. Yeah, when she said
No matter what. No matter how...
Which I'm shocked.
No matter how Marlo was introduced... What is going on? On this vibrating.
This phone is the hotspot.
Oh, I know that's right. Right between your legs. In the hotspot. So, no matter how, you know, Marlo was introduced to the Real Housewives of Atlanta, who didn't want to be friends with her, bitch, you had her as your bridesmaid.
Right.
Mind you.
Right. Bridesmaid.
Don't have to ask.
Oh,
a bridesmaid.
Okay.
All right.
And you only knew her.
Yeah, and then y'all was close as shit. Don't act like on season 4 y'all wasn't close. Oh, this is my Gucci bag, this bag. Oh, I love them Louboutins and this and that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, don't act like y'all bitches didn't become friends, because everybody, even me, we wanted to see y'all go at it.
Because that would have been a good act. Yeah. But you know, Marlo got her together. Bitch, if it wasn't for me, you
would have dressed. But we're going to get into that. We're going to get into that. Get into that. You know, but, okay, from on the show, I've seen that Kenya and Marlo met through Miss Lawrence, okay? You're always going to have people, I mean, especially, first of all, y'all on a small show. You're always going to have people that know somebody. And even with the boyfriends, like, the men done fuck Candy, done fuck Phaedra. Like, you fucked Marlo's husband. Nene was like, Nene had like a connection with Marlo's boyfriend, Charles. Like, everybody had like a little 6 degrees of separation going on somewhere. So don't act like it wasn't inevitable that Kenya and Marlo wasn't going to meet. Now, this is the thing. And this is something I learned a long time ago. I never make an assumption of somebody based on someone else's opinion.
That's right.
Okay? You never go through life like that. Yeah. I don't give a fuck what Mikel says about so-and-so. Right. If I don't know him, I'm not just going to hate him just because you don't like him.
Right.
That's wrong to go about anybody, anywhere, any place. And I know it goes on a lot in the workplace. Oh, and I don't trust that bitch. Mm-hmm. That bitch do this. And that bitch do that. And then you just go on your lunch break and you two having a talk. And y'all have a real good conversation. And in your head, you saying to yourself, she's nothing like they said she was. Now, this is my problem. Nene leaks. And when y'all had the Bailey ball, first of all, the Bailey ball, that was fun. That was just something that, you know, I should have thought to do or something. Like, it was real good fun. Everybody's having a good time. Nene's upset. Nene gets upset when Marlo shows up. But I guess Marlo's on Team Twirl now, but she wanted to know why she didn't get an invite to be on Nene's team.
Or invited, period. Yeah. She wasn't invited by Nene. She thought Nene would be the one to invite her.
Well, I guess Kenya invited her.
But Kenya invited her. Because remember, she kept saying, well, Nene, you didn't even invite me. It wasn't that she invited her to be on the team. She just didn't invite her, period.
And something slipped. Okay, when they was in Lawrence Salon, Nene already like, well, Kenya was like, since you know Nene, I would love to have you come to the event where I'm honoring Nene. That's, to me, how it started, okay? And probably from there, they probably done had conversations and stuff. And she's like, you know, I really like her. She's cool. Like, so now they get to the event. They having a good time. Marlo gets to Nene face. Nene, bitch, get the fuck off of me. You ain't on my team and none of that. And that hurted Marlo, how the way Nene was acting. So she like, are you insecure?
Because Marlo couldn't understand why she
did that. Because I became friends with Kenya. Like, are you that insecure? Are you that jealous? Are you, you know, like, you really going to go there? You're being petty. And I think that is being very petty. Just because you don't like somebody does not mean that I should not like them when they did not do shit to me.
But not only that, Kenya, never mind, keep going.
I'm going to keep going. Yeah, and let me just say this. And Nene, how can you be jealous of of Kenya and Marlo's budding friendship when, bitch, Kenya on episode 1, I want everybody to go back and watch it. Y'all already know how Kenya felt when y'all kept inviting their ex Walter to all of these events. Y'all know how she felt. And I feel how y'all feel. You know, once I meet your boyfriend, you know, I'm not going to be hanging out with your boyfriend. I wouldn't invite him to nowhere. Mm-hmm. But if I've seen him in public, I am not going to not speak to him just because y'all don't speak. Not unless he did you really wrong on some shit where I feel like I can't talk to them because they didn't do anything to me. You know, just because y'all not friends no more don't mean I should be friends. When Kenya confronted you, Nene, about that, she said, no, I didn't go to your wedding, but I see that you invited Walter. Why did you invite Walter? What's the first thing that came out your mouth, Nene? No bitch can never tell me who I can and cannot be friends with.
Never tell me who I can and cannot be friends with, okay?
And when I'm having my party,
I'm not thinking about it. Kenya's gonna be upset. All when right. I give an event, I'm thinking about how fabulous Nene's event's gonna be.
All right. Now, did she say that or didn't she say that?
She said it.
Now, flash forward a couple months later, Nene, this is biting you in the ass because you're getting the taste of your medicine.
Mm-hmm. Everybody's getting the taste of their medicine all of a sudden.
Now you see Nene and Marlo now have a relationship. You know, it's not based through y'all, it's based through Miss fucking Lawrence that they met through their separation. That was their 6 degree of separation, not you. Mm-hmm. Now, just because you're not feeling Kenya does not mean Marlo needs to be a bitch to Kenya. And for what?
Because she didn't do nothing.
She didn't do nothing to me. And plus, Marlo defended you when Kenya was telling Marlo at the table, you know, Nene came to the event. She was really mean. No, that doesn't sound like Nene. I know Nene. I look up to Nene. That's not the type that Nene is. So even in your defense, even when you might be mad at her, she still stood up and defended you at that fucking table. They might have had a kiki, but she defended you. She didn't say anything bad about you at all. And Nene, you are in your 40s. All of y'all are in your 40s. By this time, by the time you reach your 30s, you should know how to have a proper relationship or a conversation when you are upset with somebody. Like if you're mad and somebody did something wrong to you, you should know how to have this conversation. Me and Dennis, we had this conversation before. Dennis thought that I should have unfriended one of his friends that he stopped talking to. And I said, no, that person ain't do nothing to me. And why should I go off and just block them? They didn't do nothing to me. No, I'm not doing nothing like that at all.
I'm shocked that Dennis would say that because I didn't think that he would say that.
Yep, he told me to do it. And I said, no. You know, Brandon didn't have a problem, but I have a problem. And, you know, I've had friends
Brandon
in the past.
Didn't have a problem with doing it.
Yeah, I had friends in the past. Like, okay, y'all was in a relationship for a long time. Over this long time relationship, I get to know this person as a friend. And just because y'all are not talking anymore does not mean I'm cutting this person off and I'm never to speak to them again. I will never be that way. That's for anybody, okay? I'm not going to change who I am because I know in my heart that I am a good person. I am a good friend. And I'm not going to sit there and be having these conversations about you to that person when y'all not together no more. Because I'm not into that shit. And when it comes to being a friend, let me tell you something. I have some friends in the past that talk shit about Mikel. And I stopped them. Like, don't talk about him. You don't know him like that. You haven't even met him. So just because you see how he is on video and how we interact, that does not give you a right to not like him. Then when they meet him, oh, well, you know what? He's not even like I thought he was, because, you know, he was one way in the video, and then when you meet him in person, he's just a different way. And I'm like, exactly. You should never judge somebody before you meet them, or even if I said Mikel is a bad person, which I never did, but if I said Mikel was a bad person, you shouldn't think automatically go off my opinion of him. You should never do that. And when you have these, a friend is someone that loves you, that cares for you, that supports you. With some of y'all get mixed up with friends is this social media bullshit. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. I might follow you on Twitter. I might follow you on Instagram and Facebook. That does not mean that we are friends. Okay? That doesn't mean that at all. Like, you don't have my phone number. I don't have your phone number. I can't call you. If I can't call you when I'm going through something, or if you can't help me, like, you should be able to know when something is wrong with me. That's what a friend is. You know, a friend will be there for you. A friend will call you, like, you have to support. You have to be a good friend to someone. You can't just let all of this time go by or be bitter because they friends with somebody you don't like. Especially in the gay world. Especially the gay scene in Philly, it's small. Everybody's going to know somebody by a 6 degree of separation. And that does not mean that just because, you know, you're not talking, I can't speak to that person on the street. And that's what Nene gave me. Nene gave me, I'm a big baby.
High school.
And then she talking about, oh, you bullied me. Let me tell you something. A bully is someone that preys on someone that's not stronger than them. And if anybody has been a bully on the Real Housewives of Atlanta, it has been Nene Leakes. Nene Leakes gets in everyone's face of who she thinks she can be. But when Marlo got in her face yesterday, who put their tail between their legs and ran? Nene. I don't give a fuck about, oh, my son was there. Nene, you didn't care when Greg's kids was there, when you went off and argued with the family like that. You went off. So don't tell me you couldn't get in Nene and get in Marlo's face and argue with her. Like, what Marlo said was true. Like, Marlo had reason to act out. Now, maybe she shouldn't have did it there because when you argue with a friend or when you feel that someone's your friend, it's never a good time to... Oh, I feel like I'm about to cry. It's never a good time to have a conversation when you're angry with a person. You have a conversation with them over a cocktail or just in person, one-on-one. I don't do the phone shit and I don't do the text shit. Like, when my friend's upset with me, like, Dennis wrote me... I got to bring him up again. Dennis wrote me a letter. Like, he wrote me a letter and emailed it to me. And I said, what the fuck? Like, if you got a problem with me, you talk to me one-on-one. I don't do no letter and I don't do no text and I don't do no phone. We're going to talk face-to-face. A friend... Like, I've had friendships...
After fart.
Going all the way. I have friendships... Man, my longest one right now is 13 years. I've never had a falling out except for with one friend. It's and coming. Y'all know who that is. It's coming. Not on this video.
I'm joking. Ooh, that felt so good.
Okay? And that's only one person. And that was the same reason. Oh, well, I don't like that person. You can't be friends with them. You can't do nothing with that person. No. That is not me. I'm not that kind of person. I'm not that. No. You didn't do nothing to me. And when it comes to my audience is going to get what they want, whether you like it or not. I'm not friends with her. I may got her phone number, but I don't text her. I barely tweet with her, you know.
What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about. I don't want to say no names. Oh. But I'm just saying.
No, I don't. I just want to.
Oh, but, well, bitch, I don't need to say no names.
You've been talking for so long that I zoned out.
No, because I'm trying to explain.
I understand what you're saying, but speed it up.
No, I'm not speeding a damn thing up, because we at the end of the show anyway. But I'm just saying.
No, because I want to get to the part about what Dennis said to you in the letter. You done jumped all clear across
the table. No, because you keep interrupting me. I didn't interrupt you.
You said you
were. But let me tell you something. A friend will be supportive. A friend will be there for you, and y'all are there for each other. You know when something ain't right, and you know, you just know when a person is going through something. You're supposed to be there as a friend. What you shouldn't do is tell them, oh, who you can and who you cannot be friends with. I've never done that to nobody. I don't tell you who you can and be friends with. Like, it should already be, if somebody cheated on me, somebody hurted me really bad, I wouldn't expect for you to talk to them. But if I dated somebody and, you know, we're not together no more, like, I don't mind if you speak to them. That doesn't hurt me. That doesn't do nothing to me. If y'all struck up this friendship and you invited that person to the party, so what? I'm going to be there. I know how to say hi and keep it the fuck moving. I'm not going to confront you. You're supposed to be my friend. Why are you going to have her at this event and you know that we used to talk? Fuck that. Be a grown up and not be worried about them. It's all these other people at this party and you worrying about one person? Go off. You can say what you want, because I'm just getting frustrated when I just think about when you tell somebody.
Who can say what they want?
Who can be friends with who?
Who can say what they want?
Oh, you forgot who your name is?
You didn't say everything. There's nothing for me to say.
Like, I'm just, because, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Because I felt some kind of way watching that episode last night, because I had a fucking flashback.
I know.
I had a flashback.
Let me tell you something. When you start talking like that, it's nothing for me to say, because you done said everything I wanted to say. And even if I did want to say it,
I said it. Like, I just had a flashback. If either you're going to be there for your friend or you're not, okay? Now, granted.
I done seen every R&B artist from the past 50 years pop up on your screen since you've been talking.
Let me tell you something. Brandon has never told me. Uh-huh. And you know who we used to date. He ain't never say to me, oh, you can't speak to him.
No, he can't tell you that.
You know,
I can still be running, ripping and running.
Oh, don't you do that. Don't you do that. Don't you do that. Don't you do it. See? Now that's a fucking friend.
Right.
Okay? Now you not going to read my friend.
No, I'm just saying.
But don't you.
I'm not going to do it.
You can think it, but you will not say it. And I done bought clothes off this man.
You know what I'm about to say.
I done bought clothes off this man.
I'm just saying.
Okay. Okay, I know. We all know.
Everybody who in Philly don't know.
You trying it?
It's the truth. But you know, you just said
Because this city is small.
It is small. It's a small city.
Okay. Who don't know that?
Tell me some shit.
So he better not tell you that.
That's like...
He's going to tell me some shit. And every time I turn around, I get 10 more damn days. Because, oh, you was a bad girl. And you said something.
And Mikel, you better not talk to him, bitch.
You got another nigga.
You better not come on this show. You think you going to be friends with my ex?
First of all, if you think that I'm going to ever listen to you... If you think
I put my friend
that I'm gonna listen to you,
right, you tried
to. No, seriously, if you thought that I would listen to you telling me who I shouldn't talk to,
no,
I would look at you like, girl,
like, child, maybe like, don't fall for that. You can't be friends with someone to or like now. It's one now. It's this one thing that's like. Fuck them after your friend that name. Now that's a code you don't ever fuck with. Oh, well, y'all broke up, so I'm talking to him now. Now, no. You don't do no bullshit like that. Now that's going against the rules.
That's going against the grain.
And something that I seen Marlo and Nene do, and I've done it in the past, is they slung mud at each other on a computer. Mm-hmm. Like, once y'all start doing that, and once y'all start trading insults via the text messages or whatever, or in person, there is no need to reconcile that friendship because there were bonds and trust that were just spewed out everywhere and hate just coming from everywhere. That's why I don't think friendships like that, when you do that, when y'all both do it, y'all should never be friends again. Because if you did it once, if this friendship breaks apart again, it's going to happen again. Nene said all her nasty feelings about Marlo. And then she went on to read Miss Joyce. Now, Marlo, Nene, that's not something you do. Okay? She, on her blog or whatever, she want to say, I'm not Miss Joyce. I don't make phone calls and threaten people. I don't beat people up and threaten to drag them down the street. Well, however Candy felt about what happened, Nene, no need to drag her mother into this at all. Some people may agree with me and some people may not disagree with me. But I know one thing, my friendships has lasted, okay? I have over 7 friendships that's lasted over 10 years.
That's right.
And if we don't speak to each other, it might be a couple months, but you know what? There will always be a friend that will play the referee when we get together and talk again. And we're friends. That's what friends are for. You're not always going to get along with each other, okay? Mm-hmm. You're not always going to get along. Somebody's going to do something that you don't like. But it doesn't mean that you go out and spread their business on Facebook, spread their business on Twitter, and do stuff like that.
That's right.
I've never had no falling out like that. But what did you want to say about this letter Dennis wrote me?
No, I thought you was going to get into it more details, which you did. Mm-hmm. That's all right.
No, but he did.
No, I didn't think you was going to tell us what he said, but I just thought you were going to...
But I think you would know what that letter was about.
Oh, wait, I think I do.
Yeah, that was 2 years ago, yeah.
Was it? I thought it was last year.
Mm-mm, 2 years ago. That's when he wrote me a letter.
Yeah, I remember.
You remember that barbecue chat? I was a mess. Actually,
now I know what letter you're talking about because he
probably asked you what you thought of it.
He hit me up before he did it, so I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah. So, and go ahead.
No, I think I'm gonna play the fence on this one, though.
You could play the fence, but you know what?
But I agree with you. Let me just say this, I'm on your side with one thing. Don't text me or hit me up with stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So I agree, but then to come to Dennis's defense, I think that particular situation, he probably felt as though talking to you at that particular time wouldn't work. So yeah, but now everything's fine. So yeah.
Yeah.
See how easy that was. I am good. I need to start charging people.
So y'all got to know how to keep these friendships, y'all. Like if you really love a person.
First of all, I don't have any friends where I've. Did anything. First of all, I don't have that many friends. Mm-hmm. But the friends that I do have, I've never had arguments with them and we started slinging mud at each other. Because mm-hmm. it's not
that deep.
Because that's my friend. And no matter how mad I get at them, I ain't going to say nothing negative or bad about them like that. Mm-hmm. That's just not going to ever happen for me.
But I'll tell you one thing. You come for me, I'm coming right back. I'm coming back. But cherish your friendships because friendships are everything. You don't want to be a person that don't have friends. You always want to be a good friend and you want to support each other. But all of that, I don't agree with telling people who you can and can't be friends with. You should not do that. But there also should be a level of respect and you should know when or when not to test the mother effing waters. You should know that. if you want your friendships to last, there's nothing wrong with having conversations in person. Because when you have those conversations in person, you get to see facial expressions, you get to see the voice, like you get to see the sincerity. A text message don't give you sincerity. Mm-hmm. A text message could be read and interpreted any kind of way. So when you hear the tone and then your face, you just know it's everything. And let me tell you a key to how to keep a good friendship is to never judge when a person cleans their heart to you. Don't you ever judge them. That's what I love about me and Brandon's relationship. Over 13 years, he tells me secrets, I tell him secrets, and we don't judge. Now, I might have an opinion, but I'll wait for him to say, well, what do you think about such and such? And I'll say, and I'll do the same thing. Like, that's how you keep a friend, and that's how you keep a friendship. And I'm just so happy to have someone like him in my life all of this time. And y'all not going to get see me cry. So we're going to get up on out of here. We're going to get up on out of here. And,
yeah, because I'm going to miss Basketball Wives.
Well, fuck Basketball Wives.
It comes at 8?
Yeah. But, yeah, we can...
Don't say fuck Basketball Wives. I can get home.
Yeah, and make sure you watch it so we can
talk about
it.
Yeah, because I had already missed last episode because I thought I was going to be home in time. Don't tell me what I didn't miss. Nothing. I want to
don't get that wig smashed.
I want to see everybody. I want to see everybody.
Well, yeah, hurry up and get home because this show is over.
Because it's going to get good when
I can't wait to see
when they start confronting Dre's boyfriend.
Oh, yeah.
About texting Jackie.
And she won't call him an ugly motherfucker.
Now, Jackie. Okay, that's what I thought about that. Jackie, now you tried it. Because ain't nothing ugly about him. Okay? So don't you go there.
Yeah.
Okay? Because I'm surprised that he even tried to hit up your daughter. Okay?
Now, let me tell you, keep your friends. If you haven't talked to a friend in a while, call them up. And say, bitch, what's going on? Why you ain't talking to me?
Call them up. Tell them what
you told y'all about that conversation with Oprah and Whoopi. Like, they like, well, I thought you didn't like me. And I thought you didn't like me. Okay?
And it was a Tyler Perry house.
Based on
wasn't it a Tyler Perry house?
Yes.
A queen.
When Oprah went up to her and said, Oprah went up to her and said, do you got a problem with me? No, I ain't.
She looking at Whoopi and turning around and knocking
the shit out of her.
Because you know.
Shit.
Anytime Whoopi get on the View, it's like she's still smoking weed. You know Whoopi don't have that problem. Will turn around and knock the shit out of the bitch. Because she's lucky she can catch her on a high day. Because I'm sure Whoopi was high. Oprah would have got the shit. That would have been a whole different episode. She would have had the Color Purple reunion without the sick. They would have said, where's Celia? She don't work here no more.
Oh, my God. So we're going to get out of here. I'm going to tell y'all again, save your friendships. And, you know, don't sling mud at each other. Talk it out. Work it the fuck out. We're going to go. Y'all have a good week. We'll see y'all Friday afternoon.
I have cramps.
Well, go shit.
No, not that type of cramps.
Oh,